Hey there once again, YouTube. I'm Ben Ferraiuolo, and I'm back once again. Hope you guys had a wonderful Memorial Day yesterday. If you haven't already, please check out my website. It can teach you how to find, access, and analyze seismic and GPS data, how to understand the many seismic plots that people use, and my website also contains over 1,000 plots detailing a great many earthquake swarms and events on many pages. You can find a link to it in the description box below, right under my email address. Also, if you missed my last video, please go check that out now. It was the one just right before this one. It details the most recent steamboat eruption, the rapid-fire swarm at West Thumb Lake yesterday, and recent uplift subsidence patterns for both resurgent domes at Yellowstone Caldera. In this video, I'm going to talk about a recent discovery scientists made in regards to the November 11, 2018 Mayotte event. If you don't know what the Mayotte event is, it was a very peculiar seismic event that struck the world in awe. It traversed the entire globe like a large global earthquake would, but the odd aspects were that the frequencies were extremely low. The frequencies were made up of just one frequency, and nobody felt this event even though it traversed the entire planet. How could that be? Well, professionals had no idea. The event was first discovered by an amateur seismologist. I forget his name, but he kind of does the same stuff that I do, at least somewhat. Regardless, this event proves that you could be the next one to discover something strange. That proves that you should always monitor the world. You never know when it'll pay off. The November 11, 2018 Mayotte event confused many professionals for the longest time. Finally, they stated it was likely due to a collapse of a magma chamber, a very odd and very strange collapse. In a way, you could call the Mayotte event a very slow megaquake in some ways. But first off, it is 1:04 p.m. Pacific Time, May 28, 2019. We have Denver, Colorado right here. This is Colorado. We have an earthquake. You notice, remember my other videos a while back? I always love monitoring earthquakes near the volcano in Colorado. Huh? There's a volcano in Colorado? Yes, there is. It's called Dotsero, or Dotsero, and it's right next to Gypsum. And usually the earthquakes occur near Glenwood Springs, but this one occurred very, very close to the volcano. The volcano is right here. Actually, basically this entire area right here. Some basalt lava flows, and actually there have been some lava flows that issued out of here. Obviously, not from the time that people have inhabited America, but still, it is somewhat of a young volcano right in this area in Colorado. We do have an earthquake, a magnitude 2.7 at 5 kilometers in depth, which struck at 1331 UTC on May 28, 2019. Let's go to the event page, see how many people reported feeling this event. Let's see. 126 people reported feeling this magnitude 2.7 at 5 kilometers in depth. Wow, that is a lot of people to report feeling this earthquake. Now let's just take a really quick look at the characteristics of this event in the seismic program swarm. Here we are in the seismic program swarm with some of the most recent data from the closest seismic station to the earthquake near the Dotsero volcano in Colorado, station ISCO in the US network, broadband vertical, no location, or actually 00 location code, excuse me. Notice it usually is extremely quiet around here. And I already looked through the entire day. The only earthquake that occurred was the 2.7 that was reportedly felt by over 100 people, and it's this event right here. Right here, let's check out the waveform, shall we? Looks like a typical earthquake. Now, the P and S wave arrivals are a little bit more separated than what I would think for an earthquake of this depth. Maybe it is a little bit deeper. I don't know. I'm not a professional at that. But then again, here are the waveforms of the magnitude 2.7 near the Dotsero volcano in Colorado. Only this one event. Again, just one singular event. There weren't any aftershocks at all. Notice the dominant high range frequencies. Let's go to the spectral plot. Excuse me. In my opinion, this looks like a normal tectonic event. And there are some faults somewhat near here, but this did not necessarily strike on a known fault. But it did occur right next to the Dotsero volcano, so you never know. Could be connected, might not. Again, here are the waveforms of the magnitude 2.7 near the Dotsero volcano. And just real quick, here is an article from 1960 from someone who's trying to join the USGS about Dotsero. The Dotsero crater and associated volcanic rocks are located a mile northeast of the junction of the Eagle and Colorado rivers at Dotsero, Colorado. The area is underlain by Pennsylvanian and Permian sedimentary rocks of the Minturn and Maroon formations in which simple structures locally are truncated by an erosion surface covered with a series of tetrary lava flows. 1 mile east of Dotsero, the Eagle River floodplain is overlain and partially blocked by a younger basalt flow. The lava seems to have issued from the vicinity of a deep, steep-sided explosion crater a mile north of the Eagle River. This feature, known locally as the blowout, is developed principally in bedrock. The floor of the depression and the area immediately surrounding it are covered with a thick mantle of volcanic ash. Yeah, this is in Colorado, guys, isn't that weird? Which thins rapidly away from the source, locally lying on the lava surface. A charcoal sample, recovered from a tree which had been buried by the falling ash, was dated by the C14 method and found to be 4,150 plus minus 300 years old. The Dotsero crater is thus the most recent documented source of volcanic rocks in the state of Colorado. The ash is recognizable as a distinct stratum in many of the fluvial deposits of the Eagle River and its tributaries. This radiocarbon date may prove useful in dating post-Wisconsin periods of alluviation and canyon cutting in the local watershed. Very interesting. So it is somewhat young, and likely volcanic activity will happen here again in near Dotsero Volcano in Colorado. I don't know when, but someday it will. Because in order for this to happen, there must be some type of shallow crustal reservoir of magma down there. There must be somewhere. But moving on, let's talk about the main topic of the video, which is about the new discovery they made off the coast of Mayotte, which is off the eastern coast of Africa. The November 11, 2018 Mayotte event is probably the most enigmatic seismic mystery of our time. It produced a very specific dominant frequency of 0.065 Hz, which is very, very low. This event traveled the entire globe, spanning vast distances. Usually when spanning thousands of miles, frequencies tend to attenuate, meaning they tend to lower with distance. However, one of the many mysteries of this seismic event is how it spans such great distances while still keeping the dominant main frequency of 0.065 Hz, which is extremely low. If you wish to learn more about this event, you can click there to go to the National Geographic article about it. Again, this is on my website, under the seismic events menu, by location, under world. So you can go there if you want to go check out some of these plots. Now, what caused this event? Let me know what you think. Below are the plots to the Mayotte event, and here they are right here. Now, here are some very basic seismic plots showing what the November 11th Mayotte event looked like. Notice the strange low frequencies. Notice, look at the frequencies. That is odd. Almost looks manufactured or human-caused, but it was not. The nature of this event had everyone stumped, even the professionals, and I was lucky enough to be one of the people to analyze this event closely. Well, at least analyze it in the way that I know how, which is very basic and barely even can be considered as analysis. Regardless, it fascinated me that such an event like this could ever take place. By the way, again, this is on the world page under the seismic events menu on my website. Feel free to come here anytime. So now it seems scientists have actually a really good answer as to what caused this strange seismic signal. Of course, it was likely to be a collapse of a magma chamber like they said, but now they know pretty much for sure what it was caused by. Here we are at livescience.com. I'll leave a link to this article in the description box below. This article about this new volcano, you can skip past this if you want. But if you haven't, grab a cup of coffee or something, maybe a bowl of ice cream, and let's check this out. This is one of the coolest discoveries in seismology and volcanology that I have ever seen in my life. Of course, the title does say that they discovered the largest underwater volcano, but that is not really accurate. For example, Lo'ihi, a submarine volcano off the coast of Hawaii, is much larger than this newly discovered volcano. Now, I do think that the title error was an accident, seeing that in the text below, they do state that it was the largest underwater volcanic eruption, not the largest underwater volcano. They discovered this new volcano with sonar, so again, grab a cup of coffee or something, and let's read this article together. All right. Geologists discover largest underwater volcano, but it's not the largest underwater volcano. It's the largest underwater volcanic eruption and the fastest one to form. Researchers used multi-beam sonar to find the underwater volcano. The reflected sonar waves revealed the outline of the underwater volcano in red and the glassy plume rising from it. Gassy. I hope I didn't say glassy. But you can see it looks like a volcano right there. Very interesting. A strange seismic event, again called the November 11, 2018 Mayotte event, off the coast of Africa has led scientists to a mighty find, the discovery of the largest underwater volcanic eruption ever recorded. The eruption also may explain a weird seismic event recorded in November 2018 just off the island of Mayotte, located between Madagascar and Mozambique in the Indian Ocean. Researchers described that event as a seismic hum that circled the world, but no one could figure out what sparked it. For starters, the hum rang at a single ultra-low frequency, again at about 0.065 Hz, which was strange because seismic waves usually rumble in many frequencies. Moreover, there were hardly any detectable P waves or S waves, which usually accompany earthquakes. That's why it's extremely hard to locate, guys. And incredibly, the island of Mayotte moved a few inches south and east after the mysterious seismic event. Isn't that, that's a lot for an island to move, guys. That was pretty crazy. Now, scientists do have an idea why. This weird seismic hum, called the Mayotte Event, was likely the birth announcement of a new underwater volcano, according to Science Magazine. The underwater volcano is enormous, rising nearly a half mile, 0.8 kilometers, from the ocean floor. Its length of a 3.1 mile, 5 kilometer race, and lies about 31 miles, 50 kilometers, off Mayotte's eastern coast. And it came into being in just 6 months. Wow, that's pretty crazy. We have never seen anything like this. Fuelet, leader of an expedition to the site by the research vessel Marion Dufresne. Why do they all have such hard names, guys? I don't know. Who is with the Institute of Geophysics in Paris, the IPGP, told Science Magazine. In addition to the weird seismic hum, there were other clues that something big was happening. The inhabitants of the French island of Mayotte reported feeling more than 1,800 little earthquakes almost daily since the middle of last year, including a large magnitude 5.8 earthquake in May 2018, the largest ever recorded in the region. Here's how scientists found it. Finding the newborn volcano took an enormous effort, including work from organizations such as the National Center for Scientific Research in France, the IPGP, and the French Research Institute for Exploration of the Sea, according to a joint statement released on May 16, 2019. And I meant to say exploitation, not exploration. Part of that research included 6 seismometers placed on the ocean floor close to the seismic activity, Science Magazine reported. These instruments reveal the tight cluster of earthquakes deep in Earth's crust, likely stemming from a deep magma chamber that's gushing molten rock onto the sea's bottom. This magma chamber may also be shrinking, as Mayotte had sunk about 5 inches and moved 2.5 inches to the east over the past year. That's huge. That is a lot of deformation, guys. In addition, sonar revealed 1.2 cubic miles, 5 cubic kilometers of magma on the sea floor, as well as plumes of bubble-rich water steaming from the volcano. Rock samples were collected from the site that may reveal the depth of the magma source as well as the risk of a volcanic eruption. A volcano on the Indian Ocean? Now, Mayotte isn't a stranger to volcanic eruptions, but it's been at least 4,000 years since volcanoes last stirred in the area, National Geographic reported. The island is part of the Comoro Archipelago. Actually, my goodness, I'm bad at pronouncing words, guys, aren't I? Created by volcanism. As news of the strange seismic hum and the tiny earthquake spread, a group of French researchers posted a draft of a research study on EarthArxiv, a non-peer-reviewed site in February 2019, positing that the rumblings might have to do with the draining magma chamber, but researchers still have to publish a peer-reviewed study on the events, and it remains unclear exactly how the weird hum, earthquakes, and volcano are related. Well, the earthquakes and the volcano, that makes sense. Duh. But the weird hum, that was very odd. It's also a mystery why volcanoes are found anywhere near this tiny island. Unlike Hawaii, which formed because of the hot spot of volcanism roiling. Does that really say roiling? I would think it would mean rolling. Oh, whatever. The volcano near Mayotte lies within the ancient rift where Madagascar tore away from eastern Africa long ago. It's possible that fissures from this break are now a cradle for this new volcano. However, it's strange that the volcano popped up by Mayotte, which is the oldest island in the archipelago, Ken Rubin, a volcanologist at the University of Hawaii and Manoa, told National Geographic. It remains to be seen if this volcano is completely new or whether it sits on an older volcanic structure, the researcher said. In other words, geologists have a lot of work to do and they're eager to get to the bottom of this geological conundrum. So guys, it is very weird, very odd. What is going on here? Very weird. But again, notice how in the title they say the largest underwater volcano. That is not accurate. There are volcanoes that are much larger, but it is growing, so it might become a lot larger. But the thing is they said the discovery of the largest underwater volcanic eruption ever recorded. So that I think that's probably what they meant. And again, here, let's take a closer look at this picture, just real quick. Here is the sonar imagery. Here, let me just zoom out this real quick. Here's the sonar imagery of the massive volcano that spawned within only 6 months, guys. 6 months! Everyone used to tell us, oh, volcanoes take a long time to form. And, you know, maybe in some cases that's true. I don't know. But the thing is, this formed super fast, guys. This can go to show that magma can pop up anywhere and volcanoes can sprout anywhere. You think you're safe in Oklahoma? Never know. Someday a volcano could sprout. You think you're safe in the state of Maine? Well, actually, Maine a long time ago used to see a bunch of super volcanic eruptions, so never mind, you're not safe there. Just kidding. But there is a lot of magma rising up under New England, so eventually there will be a new volcano in New England somewhere down the line. Don't know when that is. But you think you're safe in Seattle, Washington? A volcano could sprout right underneath the Space Needle. I mean, of course, the possibilities are very insignificant, very, 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 very tiny. But the fact of the matter is that when magma decides to go somewhere and it finds a weak spot, it's gonna go. And it's gonna blow if there's enough power, guys. I mean, you cannot have a closed mind when it comes to volcanic activity and the power of magma. It literally does what it wants to do, period. So really, you gotta have an open mind when you're a volcanologist, guys. Too many volcanologists nowadays, and I'm not riding on the volcanologists. I like a lot of their work. They do a great job. However, a lot of volcanologists these days are kind of a little closed-minded about where volcanoes can form and how fast they can form. Well, this just goes to show that pretty much anything's possible in this world. So, can I say holy crap? This is a monumental discovery for volcanology and seismology. The November 11, 2018 Mayotte event was likely connected to this new volcano forming. However, in what way? That has yet to be seen exactly, but we do know that it was connected in some way. Isn't this freaking cool? So here we are back at my website showing some very simple plots of what the Mayotte event looked like via seismic data. This is pretty cool, guys. A new volcano was discovered and likely is connected to the largest submarine volcanic eruption ever detected or witnessed by humans. The mystery still remains as to why the frequencies were so perfect, almost looking artificial, and why they were so low at 0.065 Hz, as you can see here. And let's go back. Let's go through all these, shall we? There's showing it right there, showing it right there from Ukraine. Here's it from Canada. Yeah, it traversed the entire world. Here's one from Japan. Guys, yeah, it traveled the entire world, but it was pretty slow. And here are some waveforms just from central Madagascar, the closest seismic station to this event. High pass 1 Hz, showing there were some actual high-frequency earthquakes during this event. Low pass 1 Hz, showing the extremely low frequencies. And a band pass 0.06 to 0.1 Hz, showing just the strange hum. And that's it right there from the closest seismic station. Now again, it's so weird, guys. Now I doubt this will ever accurately be explained 100% as to why it was such a strange event, seeing that it would be extremely difficult to find out. Regardless, they still might, so stay tuned to this channel for more information regarding this event. The seismic event and subsequent find of this volcano was such a large discovery that there are definitely going to be a lot of scholarly articles on this sometime in the future. So as we can see, volcanoes can immediately form within just months, something that scientists have told us was pretty much impossible in the past. Is it possible everything on Earth forms much, much faster than what scientists think? Possibly. Remember, humans are extremely fallible and will always be wrong about something. Regardless, keep in touch with professional publications about this to see where this research is headed. If anything changes, I'll let you guys know. Also, don't forget to check out my most recent video, the last video I posted before this one. Now, I'm still working on the analysis page of the rapid-fire swarm that struck West Thumb Lake at Yellowstone yesterday, but it'll be up probably tonight. God bless, and I'll be back. Remember, the truth is often considered hate or fear to those who hate or fear the truth. See you later, guys.